More voices are being added to the chorus, critical of the disciplinary action taken by the Leonesse Comprehensive Secondary School following senior students' involvement in a TikTok video that went viral on social media last week. The students, seemingly during school hours, in the classroom and in school uniform, filmed themselves in a profanity-filled video and making lewd gestures to the camera. One method of discipline implemented by the institution for this behavior was a social media video of the children apologizing. Communications Officer for PCI Media, Bennett Charles, maintains that the forms of discipline by the institution remain questionable and warrants answers to the parents of the children involved and the public.
A school is designed to nurture our young people and ensure that they become the best versions of themselves. And critical in teaching our students discipline and shaping them into better citizens. A school should never be a place where students are humiliated by the administration of the school. And that is apparently what has happened in terms of the situation at the Leon Hess Secondary School, where students were disciplined for a certain social media post. And while I do agree with the discipline in terms of stripping them of their responsibilities as a prefect and peer helpers, when you, one, take someone's child, videotape them doing an apology, and then reposting that on the very social media platforms that you blame for the decay of young people, you're basically adding to the trauma that these young people will experience.
Charles insists that the educational institution ought to be held accountable for its actions, which he remains adamant may have caused more harm than good.
It is sad that people usually hold young people accountable for the actions that they take. But who will hold the school accountable for, one, videotaping the kids without the consent of the parents and posting this on social media, even with an understanding of how social media is a platform and a most severe platform for bullying, basically cyberbullying? What I want to know is, one, what was the reason for having the students apologize via video, videotaping that and posting it? Was it to basically, you know, show that this school is the best school and we don't take nonsense from students? Was it to inflate the ego of the administration? I am calling on a number of things to happen. One, the Ministry of Education needs to do a serious investigation into this in terms of how children were basically traumatized and exposed to bullying. Two, the ministry needs to issue an apology either on behalf of the principal or the principal himself issue an apology to the parents and to the students themselves. Three, we need to know whether the counselor of the school was involved in the decision making.
Charles is making an appeal to all students' rights organizations to lend their voice to the issue in hopes of creating a more amicable space for student development.
Because if a child has already committed something that has basically traumatized or something that negatively impacted on the school, and you now take this very same situation and you further expose the young people to cyberbullying and to more traumatic experience, then someone has to be held accountable. I am calling on the National Youth Council that's supposed to be the voice of young people in this country, the National Students Councils, the PTA at the Leon Hess Secondary Schools, the Student Council at the Leon Hess Secondary School, to hold the school and the school's administration accountable for treating the situation in this manner. We have to hold adults accountable. The Minister of Youth and Sports, the Education Minister, past members of the National Youth Council and past youth advocates. And I hope that they will not be silent on such a serious issue.
The communications officer maintains that the situation warrants serious intervention. Efforts to contact the Leon Hess Comprehensive Secondary School on the matter were unsuccessful. For the DBS News World, Jason Narius reporting.